MyPillow CEO Mike Lindell is ready for the midterms today, folks. He is going to have his cyber crime desk set up, and he says he's going to be live streaming all of the irregularities that he finds, starting at, of course, 6 p.m. tonight and going all through the night, he tells us. So here is Mike Lindell laying out his plan to basically flood America with conspiracy theories starting at 6 p.m. Take a look.
Well, I mean, I just landed in Dayton, Ohio for the last rally here for the president before tomorrow. And we have great news, Steve. I mean, we have people, we're going to be watching every race. We're going to have the real-time crime desk going at frankspeech.com, everybody. You can watch me there tomorrow night. We are tracking every race by cyber. I want all the bad guys out there to know, through the Edison Report, we are watching, and we also have another way to watch what's going on with the computers and the machines. So I'm putting them all on notice, Steve. They're all on notice. So that we are. And by the way, you can turn in at the crime.frankspeech.com. If you see anything, turn it in there. We're bringing everything to everything will be done on January 9th. We have over 200 counties are going to be hand counted in front of cameras. That we're not telling which counties yet. That we've got upwards of 200 committed to it.
You know what I love? I love the fact that Mike Lindell is still sitting there using like 90s terminology. We're going to do it by cyber. Do it by cyber. That is a statement that literally doesn't mean anything. Like, that's not a thing. What? Please, Mike, for the love of God, explain to us what we're going to do it by cyber means. Because based on a comment you made last week, where you, of course, claim that your cyber guys, as you call them, were going to be tracking the machines in real time, it kind of makes it sound like you have illegal access to voting machines. I mean, I'm sure that's not what you're trying to tell the public, because that would be an admission of a federal crime. Because you can't access those voting machines. But you did say last week, your guys have accessed them and they're going to be monitoring them. And now you're saying you're going to be reporting on what is going to be happening today. And all of this leads me personally to believe that you're telling us you and your team have already illegally accessed these voting machines. And I think that's something that the feds ought to look into. They ought to look into it last week, when he first made this admission that his guys had already accessed the machines. But no, here we are. It's election day. He's out in the open with everything he's going to do, telling us very clearly, this is what we're going to do. We have access to these things, and we're going to flood you with conspiracy theories. Now, of course, accessing a voting machine is illegal. Hacking into government property, which is what the voting machines are, is also a separate charge. Not to mention accessing voting equipment prior to these votes being certified by the state is yet another crime. So Lindell may need to choose his words a little more carefully so that he's not saying that his group is committing crimes. But I don't know what other way to take this, right? Like, you say you've got cyber guys, you're doing this all by cyber, but you cannot look into those machines unless you have illegally accessed them. Otherwise, you're basically just like the rest of us, having to watch TV as the results come in, and you obviously cannot determine whether or not any shenanigans happened based on the returns that ABC News is giving you. In other words, Mike Lindell is either lying through his teeth about what his people have access to, or he's just going to spend the evening spreading baseless conspiracy theories, which probably makes more sense, considering that is what he has spent the last 2 years doing. Today's video is sponsored by Guardio, a security extension that lives on your browser, making sure you and your information are fully protected online. The web is littered in threats, so digital protection is absolutely crucial. Guardio actually safeguards your data, warns you when you're about to open suspicious sites, stops malware and shady pop-ups, blocks phishing attacks. The list goes on and on. So if you're living your life online, like most of us do, you need to be aware of these threats and how to properly avoid getting into online trouble. For example, Did you know that phishing and other scam sites can trick you into giving away personal information or gain access to your device? And these sites are everywhere. Whenever you click on unknown links and emails, social media scams, pop-ups, and ads, you're at risk. And although hackers do an awesome job in disguising these sites to look legitimate, Guardio does a better job in calling them out. Also, did you know that when a data breach happens to a platform or website containing your details, they might end up being sold on the dark web? Yes, these things happen all the time, and Guardio prevents them, making sure you and your family are fully protected when opening that new tab. Guardio does this in the background, striking into action only when danger is detected. And you can start Guardio's free 7-day trial and get real-time alerts, suggestions, and fixes, and browse the web stress-free. One account covers 4 additional family members, so you know your home and devices are safe and secured. Run Guardio's speedy safety check totally free and see where you're at and what are your security blind spots. It only takes a second and you get so much out of it. Go to guard.io/ROF. The link is in the description below.